just an old country doctor in a little Kentucky town. Fame and fortune had passed him by, but we never saw him frown. As day by day, in his kindly way, he helped us one and all. Many a patient forgot to pay, although Doc's fees were small. Though we needed these dimes, and there was times that he'd receive a fee, he'd pass it on to some poor soul that needed it worse than he. Then the depression hit our little town and drained each nigger purse. And the scanty income of old Doc Brown just went from bad to worse. He had to sell all of his furniture. Why, he couldn't even pay his office rent. So to a dusty room over a livery stable, Doc Brown and his satchel went. On the hitching post below, to advertise his wares, he nailed a little sign that read, "Doc Brown has moved upstairs." There he went on helping folks, and his heart was just pure gold. But anyone with eyes could see that Doc was getting old. Then one day he didn't even answer when they knocked upon his door. And old Doc Brown was a lying down, but his soul was no more. They found him there in that old black suit. On his face was a smile of content. But all the money they could find on him was a quarter and a copper cent. So they opened up his ledger, and what they saw gave their hearts a pull. Beside each debtor's name, old Doc had written these words, "Paid in full." It looked like the potter's fill for Doc that caused us some alarm, till someone member of the family graveyard out on the Simmons farm. Old Doc had brought six of their children, and Simmons was a grateful cuss. He said, "Old Doc has been like one of the family, so you can let him sleep with us." Old Doc should have had a funeral, fine enough for a king. It's a ghastly joke that our town was broke and no one could give a thing, except Jones the undertaker. Why, he did mighty well, donating an old iron casket that he'd never been able to sell. And the funeral possession, it wasn't much, but grace and pomp and style. But those wagon loads of mourners, why, they stretched out for more than a mile. And we breathed the prayers we laid in there to rest beneath the sod. This man who'd earned the right to be on speaking terms with God. His grave was covered with flowers, but not from the floral shops. Just roses and things from folks' gardens, and one or two dandelion tops. For the depression had hit our little town hard, and each man carried a load. So some just picked the wildflowers as they passed along the road. We wanted to give him a monument. We kind of figured we owed him one. 'Cause he'd made our town a better place with all the good he'd done. But monuments cost money, so we did the best we could. And on his grave we gently placed a monument of wood. We pulled up that old hitching post where Doc had nailed his sign. We painted it white, and to all of us it certainly did look fine. Now the rains and snows have washed away all our white trimmings of paint, and there ain't nothing left but Doc's old sign, and even that is getting faint. Still, when southern breezes and twinkling stars caress our sleeping town, and the pale moon shines through Kentucky pines on the grave of old Doc Brown, you can still see that old kitchen post as if an answer to our prayer. Mutely telling the whole wide world, Doc Brown has moved upstairs. He was just an old country doctor in a little Kentucky town.